Alright guys, well, here's another video. Welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to do something very similar than I did last time, just a lot longer, and because we're going to actually do a real flight plan here. So we're going back to Chester County Airport. Welcome to Chester County. There you go, it's not much, but it's worth a lot. Anyway, so... I'll zoom out just a little bit here so you guys... Oh, never mind, I forgot. Foggy. So, keep in mind, XPlane does not keep snow, so I downloaded another program where I have snow and stuff. So, it's currently snowing outside. You can't see it snowing on XPlane satellite, but yes, it's currently snowing outside. So as a result, the cloud ceiling is very low, so it's going to be a crazy flight, but yet fun. So, anyway, I want to get into more depth with the checklist and stuff due to the weather and stuff like that. I kind of want to show it to everybody here. Alright, so, first off, I am on XPilot right now. Sadly, my frames per second is getting really low. So, anyway, I'm on XPilot right now, so I'm going to go to the VATSCOPE app and see what planes are in the area. So if I zoom in, sorry, this is where we are. We got one plane remotely close to us, I think. Yeah, so that's Chester County Airport, upright. We are going to fly. This is Chester County to Smoketown. Do one or two pattern works and come back to Chester County and land. So we're going from. I'm writing all this down in my little book here. MQS to, what is it, 37PA, I think it was called? Yeah, 37PA. 7PA pattern work. And back to MQS. Today's date is, I think today's the 11th. I'm pretty sure today's the 11th. Let's double check. Yeah, 2/11/21. Alright, so now I'm gonna pull up my checklist. Here is my checklist. Now we're going to get into more detail with the checklist for a Cessna 172 Skyhawk. So blah blah blah, parking brake is already set and ready to go. Just for keepsake, we'll switch that over. Okay. Ignition, we're going to start off with number 9 here. We'll pull up so I can edit this. Okay. So we got all this down. Avionics power switch is off. Avionics power switch is off, master switch, I'm going to turn that on. Alt and bat. Flaps, bring it down to 30%. Awesome. Fuel quantity, we're okay. That's fuel for now, I mean, we're probably going to use all that. Check is good. Low back warning lights is good. Avionics power good. Alright, I'm gonna turn it back off because now we know that works. Pitot heat. Remove cover and check. But there is no cover, so we'll go with that. Lights, so I'm just going to turn on beacon light, landing light, taxi light, nav light, and strobe light. Good. We're good there. Flap, look good. We got a red light, beacon light, nav lights, and a green light. So we are good. Lights are good. Turn the master switch back off. Static pressure alternator source valve, if installed, is good. Fuel selector, put it on both. Alright, we don't need to do that. Don't need to do that. Don't need to do any of these. Nose, nothing like that. Just because this is a simulator, everything's set to good. Alright, we're good with that. Good with that. Before starting engine, here we go. So this is the big part. Seat belts and shoulder harnesses are good. Personal electronic devices are turned off. Air vents are to comfort. Fire extinguisher, we don't have one in the plane, we're good. Emergency procedures are next. So my emergency procedure here is we're going to taxi up Alpha. Yeah, Alpha up to running pad, run up pad 29. Do last couple of last checks, and then set up the GPS and stuff like that. Take off of runway 29. If we do not get airborne by the time we are hit up to this entry strip, then I will abort the takeoff, and we'll stop at the next entry strip and taxi back up via Alpha. Okay, if everything comes down to worst, we'll find the fields. There are some really nice fields off of Chester County. Mission objective. My mission objective is to take off of Chester County Airport, fly to Smoketown, Pennsylvania, do a couple pattern work practices around Smoketown, maybe show off a couple things, and that shouldn't take too long, and then we'll make a 360 back to Chester County and land, and complete the checklist after landing. But that's all good. Okay, so the destination is 37 PA. Route, we're good. Altitude, okay. Non-amps. So, what I'm going to do is actually, okay, we're good. So, we're not on right there. Non-amps, I'll go over that in a second. We are good with that. Actually, yeah, no, I'll skip on that. Cockpit layout, we're all good. So, cockpit layout, we got the airspeed indicator, we got the altitude. Altimeter, directional gyro or compass, whatever, vertical speed indicator, and RPM indicator. Those are what we're going to be worrying about mostly today. EGT, I might use a little bit of EGT. I'll show you what that is. I think that's it with that part. Okay. Okay, so we're done with the mission brief now. So passenger brief, you are the passenger. You watching other passenger, so we're good. Stale cockpit, comply, obviously, because you guys aren't going to be talking to me quite yet. We'll be doing live streams soon. Okay, those are all good. Avionics power or switch, double check is off, because that's an important part. Because if your avionics is turned on when you start your engine, it could ruin all the avionics and magnetics and stuff like that. So that stays off, that's the last thing to turn off. Electronical equipment is all turned off. The circuit breakers are all checked in. Good. Autopilot is off. Fuel selector is still on both. Alright, start the engine. Prime it 2 to 6 strokes, which I don't have, so I'm going to turn off the fuel pump. Carburetor heat. I don't have a carburetor heat on here, sadly, too, because this is not a pop-up. Throttle. We'll skip that, so we'll go with that. Mixture. Put mixture in rich. Flashing beacon and nav lights. So beacon, now I can turn this off, and I'll turn this off. Because we are also in snow, I'll turn Peter Houdon as well. Propeller area is clear, master switch turn on. So what you hear now is the fuel pump going. And everything loosened up. Alright, so master switch is turned on, and now we turn on the ignition switch. Okay, the ignition switch starts. Throttle bring it up to about 800 RPM. 800 to 1000 RPM, okay, oil pressure. Oil pressure is still probably not in the green yet, but it will get there. Oh, the pressure's in the green. Oil temperature, we'll wait till that gets in the green. That pressure's in the green, we'll go with that. Starter is, I don't hear a starter, so we'll go with that. Avionics power switch. Okay. Turn radios on, we are on con 1. So now what I'm going to do is pull up the map. Click on Chester County. Details. Now this is the important stuff here. AWAS is 126.25. Write that down. 126.25 is AWAS. So then you pull up my nav. Oh my goodness. Okay. 126.25, and it's slowly going. Okay, good. So that's set. 122.7 is the Unicom frequency, and we don't need to worry about the Philadelphia ones. Okay. Alright, this is where I start writing things down. So my radios are all set. Alright, I'll worry about all those in a second as well. Okay. This is where we are going to get our weather, altimeter, and stuff like that.
Chester Koji O. Carlson Information Alpha. 1700 Zulu weather. Wind light and variable, visibility A. Sky conditions 800 overcast, temperature minus 2, dew point minus 4. Altimeter 3023. Arriving runway 29, departing runway 29. Advise on initial contact, you have Alpha.
Okay. So here's the weather. So it's a really low overcast at 800 feet. That's a really low overcast. So we'll be flying really low to the ground to stay out of the clouds. Due to the snow going on. Altimeter is 3023. Very good. And while we are at it, we are at between 3 and north. That's set. Okay, radios are good. PFD and GPS is good for now. Taxi lights are turned on still. Flaps, big flaps up. Okay, they're going up. Alright, and we already did AWAS. Altimeter, we just set. Alright. Those are good. Now we're going to do the transponder code, which is 1200, so it's going to turn transponder on. Alright, now we're about to taxi. Let's put that on. Note, start time was, what time is it? It is currently 12:55, or 12:25, so then you add it to Zulu time, so that is 12. 17:25. Start time. We are flying daytime. Aircraft type is a Cessna 172. Aircraft's number is CAP 3728. We are flying GA cross country from MQS. To 37PA back to MQS. Pilot in command is me. ERP. There is no first officer. Alright. Alrighty. We are all set. Ready to go. Flaps are up. takeoff. Oh wait, that was one other thing. I am going to connect to. Should I? No, I'm not. I am not going to connect because my frames per second is so low. Okay. Brakes off. I keep forgetting this. I always forget this. It's 26 degrees Fahrenheit outside right now. Chester County traffic, Cat 3728 Skyhawk is taxiing to run up at 29 Chester County. Alright. Try to follow the taxi lines all the way up to right up pad 29 via Alpha Taxiway. I forgot something else too. I'll check it when I get there. So one other thing I forgot. Where was it in here? It was somewhere in here. The beginning probably. But I forgot to check the Hobbs and tack time in the airplane. And I'm not too worried about that because obviously nobody else flies this plane on the simulator but me. So it should still be the same unless there's some technical problem. Taxi checklist, brakes are good, altitude indicator is good, and turn indicator is good, and HI compass is good. Notice those two things in the bottom left of my six pack are moving when I turn, so we're good. So taxi checklist is now complete. And then we're going to do our before takeoff run up checklist here once we get into the run up. And I'll also just go ahead and write down the altimeter and stuff when we get there as well. Yeah, there you go. The weather just updated. The clouds have dropped. As a result of that, I'm going to check the AWOS. Alive and well at Chester County.
Chester Koji O. Carlson Information Alpha. 1700 Zulu weather. Wind light and variable, visibility A. Sky conditions 800 overcast, temperature minus 2, dew point minus 4. Altimeter 3023. Mm-hmm. Arriving runway 29, departing runway 29. Advise on initial contact you have Alpha.
Okay. Alright, parking brake is set. I'm going to do this really quick just so I don't forget. Alright, we have. Let's go double check. This guy grabs me. Where is it? Yeah, tachometer and Hobbs. It's number 6. I skipped right through it. Alright, tachometer. This is the tach. Hours, how many hours I have in this plane. So far, I have. Oh, where am I? Tack time is 49.9. Alright, and then the Hobbs is over here. That's the Hobbs. It's also 49.9. There we go. 9, I got those done. One other thing I'm going to check really quick is the weather between here and Smoketown. Smoketown's details. Conditions is 1,100 overcast, so that's a big difference. 37 PA is 100,000 or 1,100 overcast. Visibility 7. And then altimeter is 3024. 3024. Okay, and it's 16.3 miles away from me. Alright, and one other thing I want to contact is the wind is, I don't know why the AWOS doesn't say it, but the wind's coming from 29.1 degrees. 28 knot of winds at 291 degrees. Okay, so here we go. We got all that done. Next, so now we're here. Parking brake is set, seatbelts are good. Those are good. Flight controls are free and correct. I checked that already. Flight instruments. Double check. That's good. This is good. That is good. This is good. That is good. Good, good, good. Good. Are we in the green there? We're in the green and we're still in the green. Alright. We're good there. Now I'm going to go to this GPS and double check where we are headed. So we're going N57 over here. So, I am going to, we're going from 37 PA back to MQS to 37 PA. So active flight plan, 37 PA, and then back to MQS. So I already set that up. If you guys have questions about it, put it in the chat, and I'll tell you how to do it. Okay. Don't need to worry about COM 2s for now. Good. Oh, nav. Don't need to run any of this. Okay. Fuel quantity is still good. Mixture still rich. Fuel selector still on both. Elevator trim is set to take off. Throttle bring up to 1700 RPM. Magneto check. So we're all good there. Turn magneto down one. That just dropped 100. These are still all good. Bring it up one. These are still good. And that's up again. Drop two. That drops down 100. And we're good there. Back up 100. Okay, so we're good with that. Our carburetor heat suction gauge is good. Engine. The ammeter. We are still good with that. It's in the green. Those are both in the green. That's good. That's throttle friction lock adjust. Okay, so we're good with that. I'll bring the throttle back down. Oil. Okay, now I'm going to go to my next page here of checklists. Strobe light, pulse lights, if installed, as desired. Yeah, due to the load up, yeah, I'll put strobe on. Radios are all set and good to go, already did that. Transponder code, I've done that. Autopilot is turned off, flaps are still up to zero. Primer is locked, carburetor heat is still cold, takeoff briefing is now complete. Doors and windows are latched, lights are set to whatever time as recorded. time is currently 17:37 Zulu before takeoff. Parking brake release. Now we're good to go. So, climb speed. When I take off, my goal is to stay at a climb speed of. I'm rotating at 55 knots. Climb speed is at 75 to 85 knots. That's it. That's all I really need to worry about is takeoff. So I'm going to take off here in a second and then roll back at 55 knots. Which for this plane, since this is not a pop-up, I'm going to roll back at 65. Okay. Stop. Chester County traffic. Cap 3728 Skyhawk is departing runway 29 to the west, Chester County. There you go. Totally not centered with my life. Alright. And we are going to take off, roll back. I'm going to roll back at 60 or 65. Climb speed to 75. Should have just a little bit of a crosswind here. Good, and we passed the taxi mark, so we're good with that. Climb at, a little bit of a crosswind here. And we're stay below the clouds at all times. Flaps are still at zero, carburetor heat's still cold, mixture is still fully rich. Measuring instruments are still in the green, air speed's still alive. Takeoff checklist is now complete. I'm going to level off here. We should be able to go a little higher later. I'm just going to follow my GPS heading. Now what I'm going to do is go to this new app I got called Exodon. And Exodon automatically follows me. I've put in all the information about my plane already, so we're good to go. So that just is going to give you an active, an up-to-date briefing of where I am and how far I have to go. Alright, I'm going to cut down my throttle. I'm going to bring my RPMs to 2200 RPMs. So as when I get closer to MQ, or sorry, when I get closer to 27 the clouds should look right there. Yeah, beautiful. As soon as I start talking about it, there's a little rise and opening in the clouds. So we can get just a little higher. Notice where my mouse is in the center of the screen, up far to the left, because there is a wind on my left side pushing me up, so I'm fighting it just a little bit. We're currently 11 miles out from Smoketown. Smoketown runway 28. What we're going for. Now, if you notice on the app, it says I was at 13 miles away, and then on my GPS here, I'm at 16. Notice though, its distance is now it's 12 SM, and then my GPS is NM. These are two different distances. SM, I forget what S even stands for, but I do know. NM is nautical miles. SM is probably surface miles, I'm guessing. I don't know. Maybe. But I'm going with my distance on top. Let's drop altitude and get below these clouds. Cloud covers around, should be around 1,100. That's pretty low clouds here. But just so you guys know, I am doing this simulator, and though in my flight lessons, I'm not even IFR trained yet. We've not even started talking about IFR. Oh, like that. I would need IFR clearance. Okay. My airspeed's in yellow. I'll drop my airspeed here. 8 miles out. Once I get down to 5 miles, I'll make my incoming call. Cool. If you look at my iPad view again, it shows those tower symbols. Those are, if you look down here, those are actually correct. Those are electrical lines. Pretty cool stuff there. Looks like the surface ceiling has gone up a little higher. Smoketown. You should be able to see Smoketown off to my 11 o'clock. Yeah, it's still covered in snow. Pretty sure that's Smoketown right there. Nope, that's not. Where's Smoketown? Should be able to see it in a second. I'm gonna get that up and I'll call my straight line final for runway 28. Smoketown traffic. Cap 3728 Skyhawk is 5 miles out for runway 28. For a touch and go, Smoketown traffic. So we're just going to keep doing touch and goes and doing some pattern work around Smoketown with this low ceiling. The lower ceiling, the more sketchy the pattern work gets, because technically speaking, Smoketown is, on an average, just about 600 above sea level, which means your traffic pattern outside of GA aircraft is 1,600. But obviously, 1,600 is into the clouds, so it's going to be a little sketchy. There's Smoketown traffic. There we go. Once it gets to 3.5, I'll call in another one. Smoketown traffic. KEP 3720 Skyhawk is on a straight in and final for runway 28. Touch and goes. Smoketown traffic. Technically speaking, I have to say traffic after that. Alright. I'm going to put one notch of flaps down. Right now, I'm just going to keep it at level of flight. Smoketown traffic, CAP 3728 Skyhawk is now 2 miles out for straight in and final runway 28, touch and go, Smoketown.
Terrain.
Alright, now I'm going to cover up just a little bit more and put 2 notches. So it's 20 degrees of flaps. Yeah, you can see I'm kind of crabbing it a little bit here. Be around 65. Smoketown traffic, CAP 3720 Skyhawk is on a short in for straight in and final runway 28. Touch and go, Smoketown. Throttle idle for a second here. I might not need it. I won't be completely idle. Last percentage of flaps. A little more. Throttle cut. Oh, I hit the snow. That was horrible. And pull back up. Oh, that was hideous. Smoketown traffic, CAP 3728 Skyhawk, departed runway 28, staying in the pattern, Smoketown. Smoketown traffic, CAP 3720 Skyhawk is crosswind runway 28, touch and go to Smoketown. I have to do that again. This is hideous. So I'm still on the crosswind leg. I'm going to make my left downwind turn in a second here. Yorktown traffic. Cat 37 20 Skyhawk is left downwind for runway 28, touch and go. Worked out a sketchy airport. Cut the throttle just a little more, and we're starting to descend at 500 feet per minute. We'll make our base turn in a second. Smoketown traffic. Cap 3720, Skyhawk is on base for runway 28, touching gear to Smoketown.
Terrain.
This is going to be a quick one. This is going to be a very quick one. Smoketown traffic. Cap 3728, Skyhawk is on final for runway 28, touching gear to Smoketown. Let's make a little S turn here. Coming just a little fast. That's okay because I'm just doing a touch and go. High at all. Fast. Buttered. Alright, full throttle. Come on, and go back. Smoketown traffic, Cat 3728, Skyhawk is departed by runway 28 to the east. Last call, Smoketown. Alright, so now we're done with the pattern work. I did two rounds, and that should be okay. Now we're gonna head back to Chester County. Just for keeps, I gotta check the weather again.
Chester Kochi O. Carlson Information Alpha. 1700 Zulu weather. Wind light and variable. Visibility A. Sky conditions 800 overcast. Temperature minus 2, dew point minus 4. Altimeter 3023. Arriving runway 29, departing runway 29. Advise on initial contact, you have Alpha.
Okay, I have my taxi lights on. I don't normally put these in my riding lights on. This time we're going to do a little different. So I'm going to go, you notice in down here, it wants me to keep going this way at 115, but I'm going 144, that's intentional. I'm going to come in on a 45 degree, which is what you're supposed to do to enter the traffic pattern. Just now scraping the clouds at 1,000 degrees. should find a breaking point in the clouds sometime soon. Of my iPad again, you'll see the heading where we are on right now in FQS. So we should be able to come in at a 45 entry point to the traffic pattern from FQS. Taxi point, we started, and so we're about 30 minutes in of flight time. It's about 30 minutes of flight time in. So when it gets to PADRE, that point, and from that point then I'll make my turn as a 45 degree, that'd be more like a 35 into now you see it showed up on my GPS as well, PADRE. Once I hit that, I'll make my turn under the compass heading here. Cloud level drops right here. I'll be a little lower.
Terrain.
I see the horizon. Come in on runway 29, we should be coming straight in. Actually, no, literally, we'll be coming straight into the wind because we're just running 29. Okay, I'm going to make my turn. We're at 45 degree entry to left downwind runway 29. I'm going to show you this little bit of EGT. So this is your EGT gauge right down here. So fix that. You pull your mixture out just a tad. Notice the EGT gauge rises. So once you get to your designated speed, pull it up so it gets to hot-ish. Your cold baseline. I'm not going to fiddle with it too much, but that should save you, it should get you a little faster. And also should save you some fuel. Miles out. As soon as I get 5 miles, I'll make my 45 degree call. Yeah, well, I mean, I'm already below the traffic pattern now because of Chester County. I mean, so the clouds are pretty low here. Lower than they said they would be. I've got a hard train to get there. So. And there you can see Chester County's airport lights. It's sort of 45 degree. Okay. Chester County traffic, CAT 3728 Skyhawk is 5 miles out for a 45 left downwind on my 29. Not me to press the flex. Forget I did that. I'm sorry, I'm tired. I slept until almost 10 today. My mind's gone into it. So technically speaking, if I was going to go fly real time, I wouldn't have flown how tired I am. We have a 5-day weekend, so that's good. I should be flying tomorrow morning from the same place, Chester County, and I'll be practicing pattern work. Get hours in before I get my solo on. So yes, I am still pretty solo flying, and I'm doing all this, so don't be fine. Okay, I'm going to put mixture fully rich here. Trim's still good. RPM down. Chester County traffic, CAT 3728 Skyhawk is 3 miles out for a 45 left downwind runway 29, Chester County. Double check fuel selector is still on both. Mixture is rich. Airspeed and indicators are still in the green, and my carburetor heat would be out, but I don't have carburetor heat with my motor. Alright, I'm now making my left downwind turn.
Obstacle.
So, around 120, maybe. Chester County traffic, CAT 3728 Skyhawk is on left downwind for runway 29, Chester County.
Obstacle.
also notice, so runway 11 is the other way, right? So runway 11 is the other way, so now I'm gonna try to keep my compass at 11 degrees. That way I know I'm flying parallel with the runway. Flaps down for 10 knots. If this was real life, nobody would be flying as much as you can right now. At least no GA planes would. I want to make my base turn in a minute. I'm going to check my landing lights. Landing lights are good, everything else is fine. Chester County traffic, Cap 37 flying Skyhawk is on base for runway 29, Chester County. It's going to be a long curve here. Cut a little bit more, get it to about 80. Chester County traffic, Cap 37, Plain Skyhawk is on final for runway 29, Chester County.
Terrain.
They overshot it just again.
Terrain.
And I'm high. Yep, that was a short base turn, so.
Terrain.
I'm liking it. I'm liking this a lot. Yeah, beautiful. Try to keep me on the center line. Idle. And we'll let it pull off here. And stop. This is where we do the after landing checklist. Wing flaps are up. Cover the cold lights as required, so I'm going to turn off the landing light, turn on the taxi light. Don't need strobe anymore. Mixture, lean it. And pitot heat, turn off. Okay, after landing checklist. Complete. Now we're going to go park the airplane at, let's say, park 9. I just go this view because it makes it so much easier, especially when it comes to parking, and we have limited access to it. right there. Alright. Good. Parking brake is now set. Transponder. Make sure it's still at 22. I'm gonna go ahead and turn that off. ELT confirmed not active. It is not active. Throttle is idle. Avionics and power switches turned off. Magneto, check the ground. Good. Mixture idle now. Good. Still cockpit's not turned. Ignition switch turn off. Master switch turn off. Control avionics light installed, which I don't have that. Parking brake turn off. Brake on. Fuel selector valve, left or right. PO tube, okay, whatever. Hobbs tech time record. So I go back up, look up here. Hobbs time is now 50.5 hours. Tech is 50.5, and then Hobbs should also be 50.5. Yeah, just about 5. Okay. Take that. Aircraft is secure. Flight plan is now been closed, and we are done. So now what you do is my little tradition is I mess this up for the next time. Just keeps me in check. I mess this up. All right. Make sure that's all good, and I mess this up. Mess that up so that way I know to go back to fix it. I'll turn all these off. And then I open this guy, look at him, and say he's really cool. Look at the plane, say wow, that's even better. And voila, you are now done. And then just to make it look real, you can open up the doors on that Cessna 172. Look, the weather updated. And there you go, we are now finished. Why? So, I'm gonna go back and look at the map really quick. So, this is what we did. I'm gonna turn. Nope, that's off. So, you don't need to worry about that. Turn off compass rays. Okay, so, this is what we did. We started up, went to run a pad 29, finished up the checklists, took off of runway 29, worked our way to Smoketown Airport. I did one landing, two landings, and then made up and went down to the southeast of Smoketown. Once I hit that area, we went back up on a 45 degree left downwind, base and final runway 29 parking. So that was the sum of it. But the wind slowly changing directions, because now it's 127. So the wind slowly switching, going up a little bit more north. This was, it was 29 when I come in and landed, if you remember that. But the speed is slowly dropping just a little bit. But yeah, so that's it with that. Is there anything else here? I'm trying to think of something else. No. So really quick, I did download this piece here. If you just look up Sam XPilot, this will show you. So you can switch up your springtime, summertime, autumn, winter, and deep winter, which is snow. And you can switch up your colors, which my computer can only take so much until it glitches out. And you can do a couple other things. Better pushback, you can request a pushback. I did download that. And then obviously downloaded XPilot, which we didn't use today, but I still made the calls anyway. And then Terrain Reader, which will just show you the terrain coming up, which I don't use unless I'm flying in the big time mountains. So yeah, feel free to get those. I'll put links down below. And if they're not down below, it's because I forgot. And just DM me on Instagram, Snapchat, or whatever. Just let me know if you want those links, and I'll be more than happy to send it to you. So, yeah. So now what I'm going to do is I wrote everything down on a little paper here with the checklist that I did, the AWOS, the Hobbs and Tag Time, all that stuff, and I'm going to transfer it over to my flight log on Google Spreadsheets, and that's what you'll see whenever I bring it up, is I'll just bring up what I did earlier and just have it circled or something like that so you guys can see it. With that being said, I will see you guys next time when I fly or play a game or do a video. Never know these days, I never know when I'm going to publish them because how busy I am. So I'll see you guys when I see you. In the meantime, God bless and take care.